السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام.
السلام عليكم.
وعليكم
كان لي الكمبيوتر انا لا أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. رب أعوذ بك من همزات الشياطين وأعوذ بك رب أن يحضرون. So in our previous class we discussed verses 94, 95 and 96 of Surah Al-Baqarah. Verse number 94.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
قل إن كانت لكم الدار الآخرة عند الله
آخرة عند الله خالصة من دون الناس فتمنعوا الموت إن كنتم صادقين.
صادقين.
Said to them, that is just if the abode of the hereafter with Allah is indeed for you especially and not for others of mankind, then long for death if you are truthful.
Next.
وَلَيَتَمَنَّوْهُ أَبَدًا بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِالظَّالِمِينَ.
Next.
But they will never long for it because of what their hands have sent before them. That is what they have done, and Allah is aware of the transgressors.
Yes. next.
وَلَتَجِدَنَّهُمْ مَحْرَصَ النَّاسِ عَلَى حَيَاةٍ وَمِنَ الَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا يود أحدهم لو يعمر ألف سنة وما هو بمزهزه من العذاب أن يعمر والله بصير بما يعملون.
الله بصير بما يعملون. مني.
And verily you will find them the greediest of mankind for life and even greedier than those who ascribe partners to Allah. One of them wishes that he could be given a life of 1,000 years, but the grandeur of such life will not save him even a little from due punishment, and Allah is aware of what they do.
Then, so there Allah asked Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to say to the Jews, if their argument is correct, is true, this, what was their argument? Only they will go to Jannah. No others will go to Jannah. And if they will be punished in the hereafter, in the Jahannam, in the hellfire, it will be only for a few days, that is 40 days of their calf worship. Then they will be sent back to Jannah. That was their argument. But if that argument is okay, this true, if they are truthful to their argument, then wish for death. Can you wish for death? So Allah asked Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to ask the Jews to wish, to long for death. But they will never be ready to wish or long for death, because they knew what they did. They knew they are wrong. No. Next to us. Verses 97 and 98. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. بإذن الله مصدقا لما بين يديه وهدى وبشرى للمؤمنين. من كان عدوا لله وملائكته ورسله وجبريل وميكال فإن الله عدو للكافرين. Say, O Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whoever is an enemy to Jibreel or Gabriel, let him die in his fury. For indeed he has brought it, that is this Quran, down to your heart by Allah's permission, confirming what came before, that is Torah and Injil, and guidance and glad tidings for the believers. Then, قل من كان عدوا لجبريل قل say O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam من كان عدوا لجبريل whoever is an enemy to Jibreel, Jibreel the angel who brings revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wahy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the prophets, okay, Jibreel wahy, فإنه نزله على قلبك, then indeed, he or the Gabriel, has brought this message, this Quran, ala qalbika, to your heart, down to your heart. Then, bi-idhnillah, with the permission, by Allah's permission, with the permission of Allah. Musaddiqan lima bayna yadayhi, and it confirming what is what came before, confirming the previous scriptures, Torah and Injil. وَهُدًا, and as a guidance. وَبُشْرَى, glad tidings. لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ, for the
believers.
So the Jews' argument was that the Jibreel, Angel Jibreel is their enemy, and Angel Michael is their friend. So Allah asked Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to say to the Jews. Next verse. Man kana aduwwan li Jibril, man kana aduwwan lillahi wa malaikatihi wa rusulihi wa Jibril wa Mikael fa inna Allah aduwwan lil kafirin. Whoever is an enemy to Allah. Man kana aduwwan lillah. Aduwwu means
enemy.
Wa malaikatihi, and his angels, ورسله, and his messengers, وجبريل وميكال, and to Jibreel and Mikael, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ عَدُوٌّ لِلْكَافِرِينَ, then verily, certainly, Allah is the enemy of disbelievers. Okay, so whoever is an enemy to Jibreel is an enemy to Allah also. Whoever is an enemy to Mikael is an enemy to Allah also. Whoever is an enemy to Allah, his angels, his messengers, Jibreel and Mikael, then verily Allah is the enemy of the disbelievers. So, okay. So, here Jibreel and Mikael is mentioned particularly because their argument was that Jibreel is their enemy and Mikael is their friend. And Jibreel sends or brings the revelation, wahy, to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then, as he or Jibreel is the enemy of the Jews, they can't accept Islam. That was their argument. Okay. So Allah says, whoever is an enemy to Jibreel is the enemy of Allah also. Then, so Imam, so regarding this, sababun nuzul of this ayat. قال الإمام أبو جعفر ابن جرير أبو الطبري رحمه الله جمع أهل العلم بالتأويل جميعا أن هذه الآية نزلت جوابا لليهود من بني إسرائيل إذ زعموا أن جبريل عدو لهم وأن ميكائيل ولي لهم أن جبريل عدو لهم وأن ميكائيل ولي لهم ثم اختلفوا في السبب الذي من أجله قالوا. So Imam Abu Ja'far ibn Jarir al-Tabari said, the scholars of tafsir, the ulama, the imams of tafsir, or interpreters of Quran, agree that This ayah, that is verses 97 and 98 of Surah Al-Baqarah, just we have seen, those verses were revealed in response to the Jews who claimed that Jibril is an enemy of the Jews and Mikael is their friend. Then they disagreed over the actual incident which led to the revelation of the verses. So there are differences of opinion regarding the incident. But all scholars agree that these verses, ayat 97 and 98, were revealed in response to the Jews' argument that Jibril is their enemy and Mikael is their friend. No, regarding the actual incident which led to the sabab or reason, revelation of the revelation of these verses, there are different incidents described in the tafsir. One or two or three we will discuss here. Then, حدثنا أبو كريب حدثنا يونس بن بكير عن عبد الله بن بحرام عن شهر بن حوشب عن ابن عباس أنه قال حضرت عصابة من اليهود رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال يا أبا القاسم حدثنا عن خلال نسألك عنهن لا يعلمهن إلا نبي فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سألوا عما شئتم ولكن اجعلوا لي ذمة وما أخذ يعقوب على بنيه لئن أنا أحدثكم عن شيء فعرفتموه لتبايعنني على الإسلام فقالوا ذلك لك فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سألوا عما شئتم قالوا أخبرنا عن أربع خلال نسألك عنهن أخبرنا عن أي طعام حرم إسرائيل على نفسه من قبل أن تنزل التوراة. Then there is a report, one hadith narrated by Ibn Abbas الله عنه. قال he says حضرت عصابة من اليهود رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. A group of Jews came to Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Then فقالوا they said يا أبا القاسم حدثنا عن خلال نسألك عنهن لا يعلمهن إلا نبي. We are going to ask you some questions which only a prophet can know. Then فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم then رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم replied سلوا عما شئتم. Then you may ask what you want. ولكن اجعلوا لي ذمة وما أخذ يعقوب على بنيه لئن أنا حدثتكم لئن عن شيء فعرفتموه لتبايعنني على الإسلام. فقالوا ذلك لك. Then Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said I will reply and if I reply what you knew, that is what is true, then you should embrace Islam. Then they agreed. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سلوا عما شئتم. You may ask what you want. Then قالوا the Jews asked أخبرنا عن أربع خلال نسألك عنهن أخبرنا أي الطعام حرم إسرائيل على نفسه من قبل أن تنزل التوراة. Then the Jews asked the questions. They asked four questions. We will ask you four questions. Then what are the questions? First question, أي الطعام حرم إسرائيل على نفسه من قبل أن تنزل التوراة. Which is the food? طعام means food. حرم إسرائيل. إسرائيل prohibited. إسرائيل means which prophet?
يعقوب
عليه السلام. Prophet Jacob. يعقوب عليه السلام. Which food item was prohibited by إسرائيل to himself على نفسه من قبل أن تنزل التوراة. Before the revelation of Torah. Before the revelation of Torah. That is the first question. That was the first question. Next question. وَأَخْبِرْنَا كَيْفَ مَاءُ الْمَرَضِ وَمَاءُ الرَّجِلِ وَكَيْفَ يَكُونُ الذَّكَرُ مِنْهُ وَالْأُنْثَى. This. How is the secretion sexual secretion of the fluid of the male and the female. Then, and وَكَيْفَ يَكُونُ الذَّكَرُ مِنْهُ وَالْأُنْثَى, and how a male or female offspring is born from these fluids. Then, وَأَخْبِرْنَا بِهَذَا النَّبِيِّ الْأُمِّي فِي التَّوْرَاةِ, and you may give us knowledge about this illiteracy, ummi, prophet, that is predicted in our Torah. Then, woman, waliyuhu bin al-malaikati, and who is the friend of this prophet, the predicted prophet, from the angels, from amongst the angels. This, who is the friend of the prophet from amongst the animals, friend of the prophet, friend from amongst the angels. Then, فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, then Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم replied, عليكم أحد الله لئن أن أنبأتكم لتبايعنني تبايعنني. If I reply to you, will you embrace Islam? Will you accept me? فأعطوه ما شاء الله من عهد ميثاق وميثاق, فقال نشدتكم بالله بالذي أنزل التوراة على موسى, هل تعلمون أن إسرائيل يعقوب مرل مرلا شديدا فطال سقمه منه فنذر لله نذرا لئن عافاه الله من مرضه ليحرمن أحب الطعام والشراب إليه, وكان أحب الطعام إليه لحوم الإبل وأحب الشراب إليه البانها. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم replied, the farage foot of Prophet Israel was Luhumul Ibil, the meat of the foot of the camel, and Ahabu Sharab Ilay, the favorite drink of Prophet Yaqub was what? Albaniha, that is, it's camel's Laban. Laban means milk. And this happened how? هل تعلمون, did you know that أن إسرائيل يعقوب, إسرائيل Prophet يعقوب, إسرائيل another name for Prophet يعقوب, مرض مرضا شديدا, he was affected with a serious illness, فطال سقمه من, and the illness prolonged for a long time. Then فنظر لله نظرة, then he نظرة نذر, he used to offer a nazar to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَإِنَّ عَفَاهُ اللَّهُ, if Allah wills, if Allah recovers me from this illness, مِنْ مَرْضِهِ, from his illness, لَيُحَرِّمَنَّ أَحَبَّ الطَّعَامِ وَالشَّرَابِ إِلَيْهِ, and that, what was his pledge? He will prohibit himself what is favorite for him from the drink, and from drink and from food. And that's why it happened. That's how it happened. Then they said, فَقَالُوا اللَّهُمَّ نَعَمْ, oh Allah, نَعَمْ, it's okay, it's true, what you said is true, that you said to Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. فَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صلى الله عليه وسلم, then Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم replied, اللَّهُمَّ اشْهَدْ, Allah, Allah, you are the witness, عَلَيْهِمْ, you are the witness upon those persons, upon these Jews. وَأَنْشُدُكُمْ بِاللَّهِ الَّذِي لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ الَّذِي أَنْزَلَ التَّوْرَاةَ عَلَى مُوسَى, هَلْ تَعْلَمُونَ أَنَّمَا الرَّجُلِ غَلِيظُ أَبْيَضُ وَأَنَّمَا الْمَرْأَةِ رَقِيقُ أَصْفَرُ. And do you know that? So by Allah, he says to the Jews, reply, second for the second question, is هَلْ تَعْلَمُونَ أَنَّمَا الرَّجُلِ غَلِيظُ أَبْيَضُ, did you know that the secretion of the male is ghalidh abyad, which is pure white. Then wa anna ma al mar'ati raqiq asfar, and the secretion of the female is what color? Asfar means
yellow.
Then fa ayyuhuma ala kana lahu walad, kana lahu al walad, then worship بإذن الله عز وجل وإذا على ماء الرجل ماء المرأة كان الولد ذكرا. بإذن الله فإذا ما على ماء المرأة ماء المرأة ماء الرجل كان الولد أنثى بإذن الله عز وجل. That is, if the secretion of male dominates over the female, then the offspring will be, the child, the baby will be boy and or male will be. Then if the secretion of the female dominates over the male, then the boy, the child, baby will be a female. So here in tafsir we see the meaning given will be is like this. That is, which secretion, whose secretion is before, who secretes before, like that. But ala means, ida ala ma'ruj, ala means to dominate, there also meaning dominates. So here this hadith is in unison with the scientific findings. Actually it's not, it does not contradict the scientific findings, the modern genetics or embryology like this. Then how in science this is not the part of the seer, not the part of the seer, we are saying. That is, science say in male sperms, in male fluid, there are numerous sperms in one drop itself. Numerous sperms. It is male gametes. We call sperms. Then in the female gametes, the female fluid, there is ovum. Ovum is larger compared to the sperms. Ovum, oval shape. But in the ovum, there are only one type of chromosome, that is called the X. And in sperms, in the sperms, there are two types of sperms, containing X chromosomes and sperm containing Y chromosomes. If the Y, so Y, we see X is there in both male and female. That is both sperm and ova. So what is special for the sperm or for the male? Y. And if Y combines, Y succeeds, Y dominates, Y happen to combine or fertilize the ovum, that is Y means Y containing, the sperm containing Y chromosome happen to or succeeds in fertilizing the ovum, then the offspring will be with chromosome number, chromosome setup XY, then the baby, the baby will be XY, XY, then boy, yes, allowed, boy. The boy will be, the baby will be
boy.
Then if the X containing sperm combines or succeeds in fertilizing the ovum, the chromosome setup will be XX. Then the offspring will be XX. Offspring will be male or female? Female, XX. XY, male, XX, female. So here the domination of the Y determines it male or female. So X containing sperm is also sperm. It's okay. But Y is peculiar to male. So if that dominates, then the offspring will be boy. Okay. If that dominates, the offspring will be male. So the Jews said, Allahumma nam, qalu Allahumma nam. They said, Allahumma nam, oh Allah, yes, it's okay. Your answer is correct. The Jews said. Next. قال اللهم اشهد والله you are the witness وانشدكم بالله. Prophet said, പാൻശതുക്കും ബില്ലാഹി അല്ലദി അൻസല തൗറാത അലാ മൂസ ബൈ അല്ലാഹ് ഹു സെൻഡ് തൗറാത് ടു മൂസ അലൈഹി സലാം. അപ്പോൾ മൂസ അലൈഹി സലാം ഐ ഐ സേ ഹൽ തഅലമൂന അന്ന ഹാദ നബിയൽ ഉമ്മിയ തനാമു ഐനാഹു വലാ യനാമു ഖൽബു. Do you know that this prophet, this illiterate prophet, his eyes, Aina means, Aina, eyes. His eyes will sleep, but his qalb, heart will not sleep. Do you know that? So it is predicted in the Torah. Then, Qalu, the Jews said, Allahumma naam, oh Allah, it's okay. Allahumma, Allahu, it's okay. Qala. Then Prophet said, Allahumma shahad. Oh Allah, you are the witness. You witnessed this incident. This, what they say? To what they say? Qalu. Then they said, Anta lan fahaddisina man waliyuka min al malaikati fa indaha nujami'uka aw nufariquk. So for all these questions, Prophet answered positively. Prophet's answers were correct. They knew that. Then they said, it's okay already. Then, now our last and final question. And upon this, we will unite with you, or we will depart from you. We will unite or we will depart. The jamiyuka aw nufariquk. Qala. Then, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. And what was their next question? Who is the friend of this prophet, that is of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the last and final messenger predicted in the previous books, previous scriptures. Who is the friend of this prophet from amongst the angels? Who is the friend amongst the angels of this prophet? Okay, then qala. Then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, fa inna wali jibril وَلَمْ يَبْعَثِ اللَّهُ نَبِيًّا قَطُّ إِلَّا وَهُوَ وَلِيُّهُ فَإِنَّ وَلِيِّ جِبْرِيلِ. Suddenly, my wali, my friend is Jibreel. And وَلَمْ يَبْعَثِ اللَّهُ نَبِيًّا قَطُّ. Allah did never ever send a prophet إِلَّا وَهُوَ وَلِيُّهُ except as Jibreel, his friend. So for all prophets, Jibreel is the friend. Jibreel is the friend of all prophets. Just like that, Jibreel is my friend also. Okay. My friend from amongst the angels is Jibreel. Qalu. Then they said, the Jews said, فَعِنْدَهَا نُفَارِقُكُ. And upon this point, we will depart you. So actually, they were not ready to accept Islam. Okay. Because Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they knew every truth. Prophet about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the predictions in their Torah, in their scriptures. But when the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, came, it was from amongst the Ismailis or Arabs. And the Prophet, they thought that it will be from amongst themselves, from the Israelites. So it were the prophet was revealed. The prophet came from the Ismailis, their cousins. Okay, so they were not ready. Most of them were not ready to accept it. Okay, accept the truth. So upon this point, we will depart. Walau kana wajhuka siwahu minal malaikati tabayanaka wasaddaqanaka. And if you are a friend from amongst the angels is except is one other than one angel other than Jibreel, other than Jibreel, Sivahu, then we should have followed you. We should have followed you and we should have accepted you. Saddaqnaka. Then qala fama yamna'ukum an tusaddiqu. Then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, what is preventing you from accepting me, from confirming me? Then qalu, they said, innahu aduwwuna Suddenly he is our enemy. Who? Who? Jibreel is our enemy. You said. Then, فَانْزَلَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلْ Then Allah عَزَّ وَجَلْ revealed this ayah. قُلْ مَنْ كَانَ عَدُوًا لِجِبْرِيلَ فَإِنَّهُ نَزَّلَهُ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ إِلَىٰ قَوْلِهِ لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ Then Allah revealed this verse. Whoever is an enemy to Jibreel. مَنْ كَانَ عَدُوًا لِجِبْرِيلَ فَإِنَّهُ نَزَّلَهُ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ Indeed, he has brought this message. That is Holy Quran for down to your heart by Allah's permission. So Jibreel brought this message from Allah with Allah's permission to your heart, down to your heart. It is not upon his will, upon Allah's will, but upon Allah's will, Allah's permission by the leave of Allah. Okay, confirming what came before. Taurat and Injil, and as a guidance, glad tidings for the mu'minin, for the believers. And whoever is an enemy to Allah, his angels, his messengers, Jibreel and Mikael, then certainly Allah is the enemy of all those who are disbelievers. Okay. Then, another incident relating to this revelation of these verses. It's related to the embracing of Islam of Abdullah ibn Salam. Abdullah ibn Salam was one Jew. Not many Jews accepted Islam, but only a few. And Abdullah ibn Salam was a prominent Jew who accepted, who embraced Islam. So that report you will see. Inshallah. And Anas ibn Malik قال سمع عبد الله بن سلام بمقدم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وهو في أرض يختلف فأتى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال إني سائلك عن ثلاث لا يعلمهن إلا نبي ما أول أشراط الساعة وما أول طعام أهل الجنة وما So another incident is relating to the embracing of Islam of Abdullah ibn Salam. Abdullah ibn Salam embraced Islam. So only a few Jews embraced Islam. Out of them, Abdullah ibn Salam was one prominent Jew. So relating to the incident, one narration is there. So, Samia Anas ibn Malik report this hadith. قال سمعت عبد الله بن سلام بما قدم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وهو في أرض يختلف فأتى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فأتى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال that is عبد الله بن سلام heard the arrival of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم in Medina. Heard about. Then he was, at that time he was working on his land. Then he came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then he asked Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "Inni asailuka an thalath la ya'lamuhunna illa nabiyun." I will ask you. I am going to ask you three questions, and only a prophet can knew about this, about the answers. The answers to these questions. This question. First question. Ma abari ashuratu saati, wama abari ta'ami, ahlul jannati, wama yanzu'il baradu ila abihi, aw ila ummihi. Which are the questions? Ma abari ashuratu saati. What will be the potent, or sign of the hour? Saat means the last hour, that is. What will be the first foot of the dwellers of paradise, dwellers of Jannah? Then what will be وَمَا يَنْزُوِ الْوَرْدِيلَ بِهِ أَوْ أُمِّهِ? How the child, the baby, resembles to its father or mother? قَالَ. Then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, أَخْبَرَنِي بِهَادِهِ جَبْرَائِيلِ آنِفَ. So Jibreel gave me answers to this question just now. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, قَالَ. Jibreel told you the answers. Qala. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Naam, okay. Yes, Jibreel gave me answers to these questions, what you asked just now. Qala dhal, qala. Then Abdullah ibn Salam said, Raka, that is, that Jibreel, aduwul yahudi min al malaikati, faqara ahadihi al-aya. Aduul Yahudi min al malaikat. Jibreel is Jibreel from angels is the enemy of Jews. Enemy of the Jews from amongst the angels. So how they considered Jibreel as their enemy? There is another report in Tafsir Razi that we are not going to discuss here. Then Then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam recited these verses. That is, مَنْ كَانَ عَدُوَّا لِجِبْرِيلَ. فَإِنَّهُ نَزَّلَهُ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ. This verse, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recited. Then, وَأَمَّا أَوَّلُ أَشْرَاطِ السَّاعَةِ. Then, regarding the portent of, the first portent, first sign of the hour is that, فَنَارٌ تَحْشُرُ النَّاسِ من المشرق إلى المغرب. A fire will lead or will collect the people from Mashriq to Maghrib. Mashriq means the east. Mashriq means east. Maghrib. West. Say aloud. Maghrib. So, a fire will come or a fire will collect or lead the people from east to the west, east from eastwards, from east direction to the west. وَأَمَّا أَوَّلُ طَعَامٍ يَوْكُلُهُ أَهْلُ الْجَنَّةِ. The first foot of the dwellers of paradise, فَزْيَاتُ كَبْدِ الْحُوتِ. What is that? What will be that? The liver of fish. Hoot means?
Fish.
In Surah Al-Kahf, you have seen. Then, in Sahih Al-Bukhari, that incident. Musa Khadr. Then, وَأَمَّا أَوَّلُ الطَّعَامِ يَقْرُهُ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ فَزِيَاتِكَ بِذِي الْفُودِ فَإِذَا سَبَقَ مَاءُ الرَّجِلِ مَاءَ الْمَرْأَةِ. نَزَعَ الْوَرَدُ فَإِذَا سَبَقَ مَاءُ الْمَرْأَةِ نَزَعَتْ. So, and as regards to the resemblance of the babies, offsprings to their parents, or as regards to the baby, male or female, being male or female, it is like this. Which fluid dominates, or which fluid comes first, that of man or woman, it will dominate. That is male or female. That has discussed earlier. No mention here. Then, so the findings of the science confirms to this hadith actually that we have seen. Now, next, what happened? Qala, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah وَأَنَّكَ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Then Abdullah ibn Salam, the Jew, he embraced Islam. He uttered, he declared his tawheed. He declared tawheed. He declared shahada. It is Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. I testify that there is no Lord except Allah. Wa annaka rasulullah. And certainly you are the messenger of Allah. So he embraced Islam. He accepted Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then he continued. Ya Rasulullah, O Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Inna al-Yahuda qawmun buhd. Wa innakum iya'alamu bi-islamiyya qabla an tas'alahum yabuhatuni. Certainly these Jews, these people, Jews, are liars. They will tell lies. And if you ask me about me, if you ask those Jews about me, before they came to know that I accepted Islam, if you ask them about me, they will tell lies. Then, saying that, he went inside the house. He said aloud, inside the house. Then there came the Jews. فَجَاءَتِ الْيَهُودُ فَقَالَ لَهُمْ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. Then there came the Jews. Then Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, asked them, أَيُّ رَجِلٍ عَبْدُ اللَّهِ بِنُسَلَامٍ فِيكُمْ. Who is this Abdullah ibn Salam from amongst you? Or how is he? What is his character? How is he? Actually, Abdullah ibn Salam is there. Where? Inside the house. Yes. Abdullah ibn Salam went inside the house. Not to see the Jews. Because if the Jews saw him, then they may not tell the truth. If the Jews came to know about his embracing Islam, they may not say the truth about Abdullah ibn Salam. That is, if Prophet asked about Abdullah ibn Salam, they will say something bad about him. If they came to know that he accepted Islam. So Abdullah ibn Salam went inside. Then only Prophet was there, and the Jews came there. Prophet asked them, how is Abdullah ibn Salam from amongst you? Abdullah ibn Salam is a Jew, was a Jew. Then they actually didn't know the embracing of Islam of Abdullah ibn Salam. Then Prophet asked, how this man, Abdullah ibn Salam, how is he? Abdullah ibn Salam, how is he? How? What about his character? Then قالوا خيرنا وبن خيرنا وسيدنا وبن سيدنا. He is, they replied, he, Abdullah ibn Salam, is one good person, best person amongst us. And he is the son of the best person amongst us. Then قالوا, then قال, Prophet said, أَرَأَيْتُ مِنْ أَسْلَمَا. If he embrace Islam, what will you do? Or what will be your opinion? قَالُوا. Then they said, أَعَاذَهُ اللَّهُ مِنْ ذَلِكَ. May Allah protect him from this, from that. That is, from accepting Islam. So they believed in Allah. Actually, they believed in Allah. What did they say? أَعَاذَهُ اللَّهُ. May Allah protect him. But they didn't believe in Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So, if to become a Muslim, one should believe in Allah and also believe in the messengers, all messengers from Adam to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam being the last and final messenger, we should believe in Jesus alayhi salam, Prophet Isa alayhi salam. We should believe in Musa, Moses, Prophet Musa alayhi salam, to all the prophets. But all the prophets are prophets only. They are not God themselves or revelation of God. There is no incarnation like that. Only messengers from amongst the men among themselves. Okay? They were men. They were not gods. God is separate. God is all powerful. He will not be similar, or he will not resemble any of his creation. Okay? He will not resemble any of his creation. If that happens, how can we differentiate? So, he will not reincarnate like a man, as a man, or as anything else. All are his creation, including angels, prophets, etc. Everything. So, we do not worship Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We worship only
Allah,
the true God, the true, one true God, the one true God, the Almighty, the All-Powerful. And Allah is the Lord of the whole worlds. Not only for the Muslims. Allah is the Lord of the whole world. Then. So they said, A'adahu Allah min dhalik. May Allah protect Abdullah ibn Salam from accepting Islam from that. فخرج Abdullah. And then what happened? Abdullah ibn Salam came out from the inside house to outside. Then came to them. Then he said, he declared, already he embraced Islam. Then he declared his shahada before them. Once more. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. Became a Muslim. I testify that there is no ilah. There is nothing to be worshipped. Nothing deserves to be worshipped except Allah. And Muhammad is the final messenger. Is the messenger, Rasul of Allah. Then, what happened? فقالوا, then they said, the Jews who came there said, هو شرنا وبن شرنا. He is the worst man amongst us. And only they added this much. وَبْنُ شَرِّنَا. And he is the son of the worst man amongst us. Okay. وَنْدَقَسُوهُ. And they continued his defects. Continued telling about his defects. Then. فَقَالَ. Then Abdullah ibn Salam said, هذا الذي كنت أخاف يا رسول الله. This was what I afraid of them. That is, Abdullah ibn Salam said earlier itself that they will not say the truth about me. If you ask them about me before knowing that I embraced Islam. Now, Jibreel now another report is there. Sometimes all these incidents might have occurred. All these incidents regarding Israel. So basically the same. The first incident we have narrated earlier. This group of Jews came there. That narration itself is there. That incident is reported in various words, various reports, same content, almost same content is there, but there are different narrations. Another incident is that Umar ibn al-Khattab, the second Khalifa, was first Khalifa Abu Bakr, second one Umar, second Khalifa, He used to go to the majlis of the Jews, where they discuss Torah and like that. He used to hear some news from them, just to know what is there in the Torah regarding Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, regarding the final revelation, like that, and how it confirms with the Quran. To check that, he sometimes used to visit the Jews. Okay, then once he asked the Jews, why are you not accepting Islam? Why are you not accepting Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is it is already described or predicted in your scriptures itself, your scripture, the Torah. Then they replied, Jibreel gives him wahi, or revelation from Allah is given or brought by Jibreel, the angel Jibreel, to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to Muhammad. Then we are not ready to accept him because Jibreel is our enemy. If it is Mikael or some other angel, then it's okay. Then he said, Umar ibn Khattab radiyallahu anhu said, though it is not possible, it is impossible. That is, if you are enemy to Jibreel, then you are enemy to Mikael also. So what they say? They said, Jibreel is our enemy, Mikael is our friend. Then Prophet Khalif, then at that time he was not Khalifa. Umar ibn Khattab radiyallahu anhu said, if you are enemy to Jibreel, then you are the enemy to Mikael also. Jibreel's enemy is Mikael's enemy. Mikael's enemy is Jibreel's enemy. And such people are Allah's enemies. Then when he returned to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then he described or narrated this incident. Then Prophet said, just now this verse is revealed. Verses revealed. Which verses? Man kana aduwwan li Jibreel fa innahu nazzalahu ala qalbika bi idhnillah saddaqa lima bayna yadayhi. Then similarly, so there they consider some difference amongst the angels. So actually it is not okay. We should accept all angels. We should accept all messengers, all prophets. So there is no difference. Grades will be different. But basically they are angels, they are messengers, like that. Allah says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَكْفُرُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَرُسُلِهِ وَيُرِيدُونَ أَن يُفَرِّقُوا بَيْنَ اللَّهِ وَرُسُلِهِ وَيَقُولُونَ نُؤْمِنُ بِبَعْضٍ وَنَكْفُرُ بِبَعْضٍ. Verily those who disbelieve in Allah and His messengers and wish to make distinction between Allah and His messengers. So there is no distinction. We should not discriminate amongst the prophets. So the Jews, they are not accepting Jesus alayhi salam, and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Christians, they are not accepting Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But we Muslims, we accept all prophets, including Adam and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Adam, the first man, the first prophet. And we accept all the, we believe in all the angels. Then. Now, if they disbelieve in or reject Jibreel, what's the matter? وَمَا نَتَنَزَّلِ إِلَّا بِأَمْرِ رَبِّكَ. Allah says in chapter 19 verse 64, and the angels descend not except by the command of your Lord. So angels say, we angels descend to earth or bring revelation from Allah upon the command, permission of Allah, upon the command, order of Allah, not upon our will, our own wills. Then in another verse, وإنه لتنزيل رب العالمين نزل به الروح الأمين على قلبك لتكون من المنذرين. And truly this Quran is a revelation from the Lord of that world that exists and which the trust of the Ruh al-Qudus has brought you down upon your heart, O Muhammad, that you may be one of the warders. So this message is brought to the heart of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam by Jibreel, not upon his will but upon the will of Allah. Okay, then now Al-Bukhari reported Abu Huraira said that Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man adali waliyan faqad barazani bil harb." Allah said, "Whoever takes a friend of mine as enemy will have started a war with me." So whoever is at enmity with my wali, my friend, then I will be his enemy. I will declare war on him, and he will be on war with me, like that. Slowly.